Hi friends, welcome to Easy Way. So welcome to this particular series wherein we are going to cover current affairs for CLAT and AILET 2019 examination. Now friends, we know that the exam dates are out. CLAT 2019 examination will be held on 12th of May 2019 and AILET examination is going to be held on 5th of May 2019, right? And as we all know that out of 200 marks, when you talk about CLAT examination, there is going to be a solid 50 marks which is worth for static GK and current affairs, right? So what we'll be doing is we'll be taking monthly current affairs and we will revise the current affairs through a lot of questions, okay, multiple choice questions. So this particular video pertains to September 2018 current affairs, right? And this is part one wherein we are going to discuss quickly 50 questions. We will just see the question and the answer so that it is very helpful for you guys in revision, right? So the first question out here is, former Indian batsman Subramaniam Badrinath has announced his retirement from all forms of cricket on 31st of August 2018, right? So he belongs to which state? So you need to tell me which state does Indian batsman Subramaniam Badrinath, S. Badrinath, belongs to, right? Now the answer for this particular question is Tamil Nadu. Now friends, you need to understand that whenever we are talking about a sports personality, okay, you need to know to which particular sports does that particular personality belong, okay. Secondly, you also need to know from which state that personality is, right? Now question number two out here, government has approved the participation of India Khokho team at the first international Khokho championship from 1st to 4th September 2018, which is to be held in which country? Now this question is important because you can see here it is a first international Khokho championship in which Indian team would participate, right? So let us have a look at the country in which this particular sports meet is going to take place, right? So the answer is England. So kindly make sure you know the venue, right? The question number three says, which Indian boxer won gold medal in men's 49 kg boxing at the Asian Games 2018 in Indonesia? Now friends, from this particular question, you can also take away an important information regarding the Asian Games. So the Asian Games 2018 were held in Indonesia. Mark this particular point as well. Now we are talking about men's boxing, right? And here there's an Indian boxer who won gold medal. The answer for this question is Amit Fungal, right? And now friends, let me tell you that there are so many other information as well. You might also get a question like, Amit Fungal is related to which of the following sports? So the answer is boxing, right? So these are some of the important points that you need to note, right? Coming to question number four, friends, it says, how many medals did India win at the 18th edition of Asian Games 2018, which was held in Indonesia? So obviously the medals tally is important. So India won a total of 69 medals. So this is important. Kindly make sure you know this number. Moving on to question number five, it says, who was India's flag bearer for the closing ceremony of Asian Games 2018 held in Indonesia? Again, it is regarding India's flag bearer. The answer for this question is Rani Rampal. Now friends, a question for you here. Now you need to tell me, Rani Rampal is associated with which sport? Okay, so this is what you need to write down in the comment section below, because only then this series will become interactive. So many information we need to gather, and that needs to be done in an effective manner, right? So now question number six, it says, former India pacer Rudra Pratap Singh announced his retirement from all forms of cricket. Okay, so again, which state does he belong to? We are talking about RP Singh right here. Okay, so the answer for this particular question is Uttar Pradesh. So we saw two important retirements from the field of cricket. Okay, one was regarding Badrinath and the second was regarding RP Singh, right? So the next important question, question number seven, Morna Nielsen has announced her retirement from all forms of cricket. So which country does she belong to? So again, a question on retirement from cricket. So the answer is New Zealand. Okay, so again, you can just have an understanding that Morna Nielsen is associated with, first of all, cricket, and she belongs to New Zealand, right? Next, question number eight, friends, it says, Alastair Cook, who announced his retirement from international cricket, belongs to which country? A very prominent player, friends, Alastair Cook, he has taken his retirement. So you need to tell me from which country does he belongs to, right? The answer is England. Again, a very important question. Make sure you know the answer for it. So coming to question number 9, it says which racer won the Italian Grand Prix in 2018. So these are Formula 1 races and these are very important questions. So regarding Italian Grand Prix, you need to tell me the winner. So it is Lewis Hamilton, the very famous racer. Now you need to tell me which country does Lewis Hamilton belong to. Okay, this is again a very prominent question. You need to write down in the comment section below. Next, question number 10, it says who has become the first female athlete to be named the most valuable player in the 18th Asian Games by the Olympic Council of Asia? Again, a very important question. The answer for this particular question is Rikaku Iki. Okay. Now, friends, another question for you guys. You need to tell me to which country this particular female athlete belongs to. Okay. So, till now, you need to give me the answers for three questions out here. Okay. Rani Rampal belonging to which sport, right? And Lewis Hamilton belonging to which country? And Rikaku Iki also belonging to which country, right? Then coming to question number 11, it says, who was elected as the 13th president of Pakistan? Okay, important question. Appointments, major dignitaries of various countries, we usually get questions on that, right? So the answer for this particular question is Ehtisaz Ehsan. Okay, he is the 13th president of Pakistan. Moving on to question number 12, it says who has been named for 2018 Dr. B.C. Roy National Award as an Eminent Medical Person of the Year, a very prominent award. The answer for this particular question is Dr. B.K. Mishra. So kindly memorize this. Coming to question number 13, it says the Panch Patmali Bauxite Mine of which PSU, that is Public Sector Enterprise, has won 5 awards at the concluding ceremony of 20th Mines Environment and Mineral Conservation Week, which was held on 1st September 2018. Okay, you need to tell me the name of the Public Sector Enterprise. So the answer is National Aluminium Company Limited, that is NALCO. Okay. Moving forward, name the app which is launched by the Minister for Commerce and Industry and Civil Aviation, Suresh Prabhu, that will simplify the work of field functionaries and enhance the work efficiency in the coffee plantation field, a very prominent app that has been launched recently. The answer for this question is Coffee Connect, right? So friends, whichever app is being launched, any important scheme being launched, any portal, so all these things are very important for us, right? Next question number 5, Minister of Railways and Coal Piyush Goyal has launched a mobile app which is named what of Indian Railways e-procurement system that offers information and data which is related to e-tendering and e-auction activities of Indian Railways. The answer for this question is Apurti. Okay, so kindly make note of this, right? Moving on to question number 16, it says, what was the theme of the 4th Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation Summit that was held in Kathmandu, Nepal on 30th and 31st of August 2018? Okay, friends, though this is something which was held in August, we have still included in this video because it was prominent. Okay, now here understand that these are regional economic cooperations and one of it is very prominent BIMSTEC. Okay, now friends, please participate, write down in the comment sections the countries which are part of BIMSTEC. Okay, and the summit was held in Kathmandu, Nepal. So this is one information again that you need to note. Okay, and now you need to identify the theme of this particular summit. The theme is, friends, towards a peaceful, prosperous and sustainable Bay of Bengal region. So this was the theme. Make sure you memorize this particular theme. And again, I'm pointing out, please do write the names of the countries that belong to BIMSTEC, right? Moving on to question number 17, it says, who was crowned the Yamaha Fesino Miss Diva, Miss Universe India 2018? Again, an important beauty pageant. Now, the answer for this particular question is Nehal Chudusama, right? So, please make sure you memorize this particular answer. Now, coming to question number 18, it says Supreme Court decriminalized part of the law under section dash of the IPC, which criminalizes consensual unnatural sex on 6th of September 2018. Friends, a very important development. You need to tell me which section of the IPC. So the answer for this particular question is section 377, and this particular development has upheld the rights of a particular section of our country, a very important landmark judgment given. Coming to question number 19, friends, as per the scheme which is approved by the Supreme Court on 5th of September 2018, what is the minimum compensation which has to be granted to the survivors of rape and sexual assault? The answer for this particular question is rupees 4 lakh, okay, a very prominent step taken by the Supreme Court. Next, question number 20, friends, which of the following urban cooperative bank's license was cancelled by the Reserve Bank of India on 1st of September 2018? The answer to this particular question is Bilwara Mahila Urban Cooperative Bank. RBI cancelled the license of this particular cooperative bank, right? So coming to question number 21, it says who has been appointed as a new managing director and CEO of HDFC Life for a term of 3 years. Now all the announcements plus whatever appointments are being made regarding new dignitaries taking various positions, it is important. Now the answer for this particular question is Vibha Padalkar, right? So please memorize this. So coming to question number 22, it says where was a rapid trident, a joint military exercise among Ukraine, US and NATO, that is North Atlantic Treaty Organization nations held in the year 2018. So very important, name of the exercise is rapid trident. Okay, you need to tell the location. So it was held in Ukraine, right? And let me just give you a question out here. Tell me the capital of Ukraine, right? And friends, be sure that you know the names of all the important exercises taking place between various nations, and specifically the exercises in which India is involved, right? Moving to question number 23, friends, Lockheed Martin has signed an agreement with which company for the production of wings of F-16 Block 70 fighter jets in India as a part of Make in India initiative, right? So we are promoting a lot of manufacturing activities under Make in India initiative. So you need to tell me, Lockheed Martin, a very prominent foreign country, has signed an agreement with which of the following Indian companies, right? The answer for this particular question is Tata Advanced System Limited. Okay. Next, moving on to question number 24. Where was the 4th Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multi-Sectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation Summit held on 30th and 31st of August 2018? Now, friends, if you have been listening to these questions very carefully, we have actually discussed the answer for this particular question in one of the previous questions of ours. Okay, so there is where your concentration is required. In fact, I mentioned the answer there also. So the answer for this particular question is Kathmandu, Nepal. Remember, we have discussed the theme of this particular summit previously in one of the questions. Here you are seeing the venue again. Plus, I have also asked you to mention the names of the countries who form a part of BIMSTEC in the comment section below. Next, coming to question number 25, where was the 6th Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, RCEP, Trade Ministers meeting held in 2018? Okay, so this is again one of the important organizations, multilateral organizations that is coming to the forefront, RCEP. Okay, so you need to tell me where was the Trade Ministers meeting held, okay? The answer is this particular meeting took place in Singapore, right? Now coming to question number 26, it says which became the first state of India to settle claims under the public health insurance scheme Ayushman Bharat in the year 2018. This is a very important health scheme that was launched in the Union Budget 2018, right? So you need to tell me which state in India has become the first to settle claims under this particular public health insurance scheme. The answer for this particular question is Haryana. So Haryana has taken that particular lead. Okay. Coming to question number 27, friends, Reserve Bank of India has implemented the internal ombud scheme 2018 and directed all the scheduled commercial banks with more than how many branches to appoint an internal ombudsman, a prominent authority who takes complaints. Okay, so you need to tell me that what is the required number of branches for one to qualify and appoint an internal ombudsman. The answer to this particular question is if a bank has more than 50 branches, they are obliged to appoint an internal ombudsman as per the directions given by the Reserve Bank of India, right? So coming to question number 28, it says External Affairs Minister Mrs. Sushma Swaraj inaugurated the third Indian Ocean Conference. So where was this particular conference held? Now friends, always remember you need to know the venue of all the important conference, and as you can see, this particular conference was inaugurated by India's External Affairs Minister Mrs. Sushma Swaraj. So it becomes all the more important. So this particular conference was held in Hanoi, Vietnam. Okay, so kindly make sure you know this answer. Next, moving on to question number 29, it says name the cyber insurance policy for individuals which is launched by HDFC Ergo General Insurance Company. Now friends, why I have included this particular question is because this is a unique policy related to cyber insurance. Okay, so that's why I've included this particular question. The answer is AILET Secure. Okay, so kindly memorize this particular answer. Now coming to question number 30, it says Paytm Money Limited has launched its app for mutual fund investments. It offers SIPs, that is nothing but systematic investment plans, for as low as dash rupees. So you need to tell me the minimum amount that you can invest in these SIPs. So the answer for this particular question is rupees 1000. Okay. So let us have a look at question number 31 now. It says, where was the annual combat exercise Youth Abhyas between Indian and the US armies held in 2018? So here, apart from seeing the venue, you can also take one important information that the combat exercise that takes place between Indian and the US armies, it is named as Youth Abhyas. So this can be a question. Youth Abhyas is an exercise between which two countries? So it is between India and US armies, right? The answer for this particular question is Chaubatia, Uttarakhand, right? Coming to question number 32, it says which financial institution has launched S&P BSE Private Banks Index to measure the performance of private banks? This is important. The answer for this particular question is Asia Index Private Limited. Okay, so please memorize this. So friends, coming to question number 33, so it says name the Indo-Kazakhstan joint army exercise which was held between the Indian and the Kazakhstan army in the Otar region of Kazakhstan, right? So again, as I have previously also mentioned, that all the important exercises that takes place between various countries is important, and you need to tell me the name of this particular exercise between India and Kazakhstan. The answer for this particular question is Kazind. Okay, so make sure you know this particular answer. Moving on to question number 34, it says which country's navy has won the Kakadu Cup 2018 in Australia, conducted during the Kakadu Multilateral Maritime Exercise? Okay, the answer for this particular question is India. So please memorize this. Okay, moving on, next one, Slinex 2018 was a joint naval exercise which was held at Visakhapatnam between India and which country? Now again, we have another question related to the joint exercises between various nations. The answer for this particular question is Sri Lanka. So the exercise between India and Sri Lanka, the naval exercise, is named as Slinex. And we also saw the joint military exercise between India and Kazakhstan, right? So please make sure you remember all these things. Next, coming to question number 36, it says, where was the 6th East Asia Summit Economic Ministers Meeting plus 15th India ASEAN Economic Ministers Meeting held? Okay, the answer for this particular question is Singapore. So both these things were held together, right? And coming to question number 37, which team won the Duleep Trophy at Dindigul in Tamil Nadu, right? So you need to tell me the name of the team. So the answer is India Blue. Okay, next, moving on to question number 38, name the triple jumper who became the first Indian to win a medal at the IAAF Continental Cup by winning bronze medal at Ostrava, Czech Republic. Okay, so you need to tell me the name of that particular Indian who is a triple jumper. So the answer for this particular question is Arpinder Singh. Okay, now friends, you can also understand here that a question might be asked, Arpinder Singh is related to which of the following sports? Okay, so now you have this particular information with you as well. Moving on to question number 39, it says which company was awarded the best Wi-Fi service provider award at the My India Wi-Fi India Summit and Awards 2018, which were held in New Delhi? Okay, the answer for this particular question is BSNL, right? Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited. Moving on, question number 40. Which organization is awarded the 2008 Balzan Prize for Humanity, Peace and Fraternity Among People? Okay. The answer for this particular question is Terre des Hommes. Okay. So it's a French name. You can have a look at this. So coming to question number 41, it says, who was presented the inaugural Meryl Streep Award for Excellence at the first Women in Film and Television India Awards in Washington? So you need to tell me the name of that particular dignitary. The answer for that particular question is Aishwarya Rai, right? Next, moving to question number 42, name the web portal that has been launched by Minister of Railways and Coal, Mr. Piyush Goyal, to enable the corporates and the PSUs to contribute to upgradation through Corporate Social Responsibility Funds, CSR funds, okay? The answer for this particular question is Rail Sahyog, okay? Moving on to the next question, Union Minister for Minority Affairs Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi has launched India's first NSP mobile app in New Delhi. Now you need to expand NSP. So the answer for this particular question is National Scholarship Portal. Coming to question number 44, name the app which was developed by the e-commerce company Desta Global and launched on July 1st, 2018 that has brought over 40,000 farmers and buyers under one roof. So this was an important development. So we have included this particular question here. The answer for this particular question is Siddhi, a very important app. Next, where was the Asian World Economic Forum held in 2018? So it's ASEAN, okay, Association for Southeast Asian Nations, okay. So the World Economic Forum held in 2018 was in which country? The answer for this particular question is Hanoi, Vietnam. So kindly make note of this. Next, question number 46. Investment firm Temasek has signed an agreement to invest up to $400 million in NIIF of India with an option for co-investment with this particular fund in the future. You need to expand NIIF. So friends, let me tell you why I have included this particular question. So this fund that we are referring to is a very important fund in India, and this is an important development. So in examination, you might just be asked a very simple question to expand this particular fund. The answer is National Investment and Infrastructure Fund. So make sure you know the full form for it, right? Coming to question number 47, friends, who was appointed the new CEO and MD of Axis Bank, a very important private bank in India? The answer is Mr. Amitabh Chaudhary. So make sure you know the answer. Question number 48, friends. India Post Payments Bank has tied up with which payments technology company for providing banking solutions to unorganized sector, okay? Especially the rural households, small and medium enterprises and women, right? The answer for this particular question is Financial Software and System, FSS. So this tie-up is important. So coming to question number 49, which insurance company signed an agreement with Central Depository Services India to provide group insurance coverage to all eligible DMAT account holders? So something related to the share market. Okay, so you need to tell me the answer. The answer is Life Insurance Corporation of India, LIC, right? Last question, friends, for today. Name the head of the panel formed by SEBI that has proposed to relax foreign fund ownership rules. Okay. So whatever important committees or commissions have been formed, you need to know the head of those committees. Okay. So the answer for this particular question is H.R. Khan. So this is a panel which is formed by SEBI, led by H.R. Khan, okay, which has proposed to relax the foreign fund ownership rules. Even if you're not able to understand what they're talking about, kindly know the name of it, right? So friends, if you want to download the PDF of this particular lecture, you can go to our website www.easyway.co.in. By tomorrow, we shall put the PDF there. You can log in or sign up, enroll in the free course and kindly download this particular PDF. So the course would look something like this, which you can see on your screens. It's a free course. You can go and enroll there. And friends, what else do we have? On the similar lines, we have a current affairs test series, which is designed exclusively for current affairs section and static GK for law entrance examinations, wherein you will get questions plus explanations also. Here, we did not have the time to discuss each question in detail, but there for each question, you will get multiple other important points as well, right? We also provide you notes on important static GK topics. And all this you can avail for a price of ₹799. The validity of the course is till 30th of June 2019. And friends, with this, we have come to the end of this particular video. I really want you all to participate so that we can finish this current affairs portions as quickly as possible. So today is the first video wherein we dealt with current affairs related to September 2018. This is just part one. We have part two, part three as well. And then we will move on to the next month, that is October. Right? And if you have any queries regarding strategy, kindly do mail us at mail@easyway@gmail.com. You can also give us a call on 8968984790. Till then, friends, as I always tell you guys, keep practicing and keep revising. Thank you so much.